فقد مضى زمان يستعمل فيه الدين متكئا لسياسة الاشخاص، وقد مضى الزمن الذي يستغله من سمي بامير المؤمنين ظلما ليعيس في الارض فسادا. فما امير المؤمنين الا رجل اقام ميزان الحق عليه اولا، ووزن نفسه بالشريعة ثانيا، ووضع ميزان الاسلام عليه وعلى اسرته ثالثا، فهذا امير المؤمنين. اما ان يكون اميرا ببيعة تؤخذ قهرا، او بانتخاب يؤخذ تزويرا ورشوة، فهذا ليس اميرا لاحد، انما هو امير هوى ونفسه وشهواته. حقيقة يجب ان اعلنها.
Whilst those who had heeded the Prophet's calls and already given their allegiances to Ali were busy burying Muhammad, a secret meeting was being held between several tribal leaders in a small hut or saqifa in an attempt to secure the future leadership of the Ummah. These leaders all sought to grasp the rulership of the Islamic nation, in turn ensuring that only they were the sole beneficiaries of power.
Initially, what happened was there was a conspiracy to conceal the Prophet's death. There were calls made that anyone claiming that the Prophet has died will be beheaded. In other words, the idea was to contain the situation, control the emotional outpour that would inevitably ensue after the Prophet's martyrdom or passing away, and the idea was to contain all of that until some sort of an interim government was in place. It wasn't a democratic process. It wasn't a lobbying process taking place. It was essentially a bunch of people fighting one another over the opportunity to fill